December friends. In the full summer of our lives, we made our friends largely by happenstance. We found one another either through our children, work, school, church, or just being neighbors on the street. Whatever way we met our friends, we were probably drawn to them by some aspect of personality that suited us. We didn't examine the reasons or analyze how it happened. We just had friends the way trees have leaves, the natural way. Here, living in a retirement community, it's a different story, and in my view, a more poignant one. We have been thrown together by the most fundamental of reasons. We are all coping as best we can with nature's fearsome twins, age and health. These give a different focus to friendships made in a place like this. When one of us goes downhill or lands in the hospital, the news spreads like a brush fire. We can empathize in a deeper way than ever before. It's as if we were all holding hands in a community buddy system. In the December of our lives, we had the chance to come into contact with people who took such a different path from our own that knowing them opens a page in a book we always meant to read but never had the time. The path not chosen is our dinner companion, who brings us a glimpse of a different way to be in the world. Like the armchair tourist, we can hear all about it but don't have to go there. At our age, it's dangerous enough just staying put. We are like comrades in arms, facing a different kind of war, but in the trenches nevertheless. There is a lull in the struggle, and we, like timeless soldiers, listen to one another's stories, pass the coffee, and try not to be distracted by the sound of deadly fire. We tell jokes, share news from home, laugh at what we can, and look out for one another. That's comradeship, no matter what month.